Steve Dotto here. How the heck you doing this fine day? Me? I gotta say, I'm living the high life, and it continues today because we have a fascinating topic. We're going to be talking about email, but not our normal email client software. Oh, no, no, no. We're going to be talking about email management software for things like newsletters. That's coming up today on Dotto Tech. Ask Dotto Tech is the show where you ask and I answer questions. And the questions you can ask are anything technology related. And you ask them right here in the YouTube channel, where we go and we find a question from my friend Pedro Albertos, who says, "Howdy, Steve, I've got a question for you. I need to start a mailing list and I'm not sure how to do it. Is there an app or format in Google or Gmail to do it easily?" Pedro, Gmail and Outlook, other email apps, are not really designed for mail list management. Now, when you say mail list, I'm assuming that you want to maybe create a newsletter or do some marketing or something that's larger than interpersonal communications. Our Gmail software, Outlook, Apple Mail, it's all designed for personal communications. Now, to be fair, you can build lists, but those lists typically are small and they contain people who you're intimately in communication with. Maybe a list of people who you share driving to school or you share driving to hockey practice in the morning, in case you got four or five parents all on that list. And what the list becomes is a convenient way to communicate with all of them. And kind of permission is implicit in the fact that you know these people and you're talking to them on a regular basis. It's great for community type stuff like that. If you're actually building a list that's based on a broader interest, or especially if you're building a mail list for business where you're going to be producing a newsletter or you're going to be creating some sort of emails that grow your brand and introduce you to customers and ultimately you might want to do some commerce out of, then your personal email software is definitely not the place that you want to build that list. There's a class of software called email marketing software or autoresponder software that's designed for that. And I've got three examples of that here on my computer. I've got Constant Contact, which you see here. I've got AWeber, and I've got MailChimp. And these are all introductory level or entry level autoresponder or email marketing packages that you can start out with. And usually you can start out with these packages for free or for a very inexpensive monthly fee, but they allow you to build your list properly, both and safely and legally, which are all issues. Now, what is special about this software compared to using Gmail? Well, the first thing that all of this software has is it has the ability for you to have people subscribe and unsubscribe from the list. That is a hallmark of email marketing software. First of all, legally, you need to be able to give people the ability to unsubscribe from your list if they are subscribed to, and all of this software enables that. The other thing that it enables them to do is to subscribe to your list, which allows you to grow it. And all of the tools include, with their subscription capabilities, the ability for you to send out subscription links within your email or to embed them within your website. We've all done it. We've gone to a website and there's been a question saying, if you want more information on this, if you want to download this free PDF, if you want to sign up for our newsletter, enter your name and email address here. And then one thing usually happens if you're a good email marketer is, as soon as somebody has entered their information, an email is immediately sent to their system verifying that they are indeed the ones who applied in order to join that mail list and opting in and completing what we call the opt-in process. And it's called double opt-in because first thing they had to do is enter their name and email address in the web form, and then they had to reply in their email. So we have now an audit trail of the person actually saying that they want to be on the list and then confirming that they want to be on the list. And that's a very important and very professional way to approach things. All of this software does that. Other things that email marketing software will do for you includes having email templates and managing your lists and allowing you to segment the list into a variety of different special interests and ultimately build funnels or email marketing sequences or communication sequences where you might send out somebody a series of emails introducing them to more and more intimate details of a product or service that you may be selling. Basically, what email marketing software does is it allows you to engage in an email conversation with your clients and give you the total control over that conversation. And it ultimately can grow into full-blown CRM or customer relationship management software. For example, I started out using a tool called AWeber, which is this tool right here. And I outgrew AWeber over a period of years, over a couple of years, and have moved on into a program called Infusionsoft, where I now manage all of my business. And Infusionsoft allows me to do things like have shopping carts and far more tactical communications with the people I'm talking to, such as knowing exactly when they click on a link, all sorts of things like that. But you're asking about starting. So rather than starting at the deep end of the pool with Infusionsoft, let's show you just a little bit of probably the one that I would recommend more often than any of the others. While Constant Contact is a terrific tool, very popular, it really holds your hand all the way through things. It's got great customer support, but I think it's a little limiting as far as the growth path that it gives you. AWeber is a little quirky. I like AWeber a lot. Technically, it's very good, but there are just some things about it that cause me to go, it's not really my favorite app. MailChimp, however, I do like a lot. Not that it doesn't have its warts, but if I had to recommend one to start with, it would probably be MailChimp. So let's just kind of log in. Now, I don't have a paid for account in MailChimp. I've got a free account in MailChimp, which allows you to just kind of start out and send a few thousand emails, I think it is, per month for free. But just taking a look at the dashboard is what I wanted to look at. When you start out, you can set up campaigns, lists, start building your audience, invite your colleagues, and are all the kind of the introductory things that they ask you to do. So let me just talk to you a little bit about what happens here so that you have a more complete picture of what happens in the email software. Campaigns are a series of emails that we create within our email autoresponder that allow us to basically send a sequence of emails. It can be what every day, it can be every other day. For example, anybody who signs up for my Evernote course, they get a series of emails, 10 or actually 11 consecutive days, they get an email. And if you take a look here, this is the actual sequence as it looks in Infusionsoft. And each of these little icons represents a new email going out on subsequent days. And within Infusionsoft, I can actually see who is receiving those emails on what days and where they are in that sequence. That's a campaign. Now, that can be used to promote a product or to deliver a product, as is in the case of that way I'm using it to deliver my course on Evernote. So all of these packages allow you to create campaigns, which are very powerful marketing tools. Lists are basically where you have people opt in, sign up for your newsletter, sign up for your campaigns, and we manage their names and email addresses on those lists. And we can have people on multiple lists. They might be interested in two or three different products that we're talking about and topics. So you could say have a list of people that were interested in productivity, to let's say it's a productivity space, and Evernote and other people that are interested in task managers. And then I would combine all of those lists for my weekly email. That's a typical way that email marketers would use the lists in order to reach their community. They can send to everybody if it's general interest, or they can segment it to vertical interests by managing their lists properly. And each of these packages handles lists in a different way. Some of them use tags for representing people on lists, and other ones have just full lists themselves that are demarked uniquely. Infusionsoft, one of the things I love about it is everybody's on a single list, and then we split them out through the tags that we apply, which gives us tremendous flexibility in how we manage people in Infusionsoft. And then we talk about building our audience. And building your audience is, actually, I'll just jump into here, because building your audience means that you can create sign-up forms. And those sign-up forms can be forms that you email out to people or that you embed in your website. So if I just click here on the embedded forms, what'll happen is it will actually start to create a form that looks like this preview that we see here. And this is what the code looks like that we actually plug in to our WordPress website, which will then create this form on our website. If you go to my website right now, there'll be a pop-up invite for you to join one of my mail lists that'll happen a few seconds after you visit the site. In other places in my site, there'll be actual physical forms embedded right into the pages. All of these serve to capture people who might be interested in the sorts of communication, the sort of stuff that I create, the sort of content I create, allows them to sign up for the appropriate list, tells me and identifies to me that they are interested in those things, and then allows me to email to them as we go along. And when they get bored, or when they get too busy, or if they decide that they don't like my content, at the bottom of every single email is an unsubscribe button. And all they have to do is click on that, and then my email software is notified this person no longer wants to receive these communications from me, and they're removed from the list. It's a very nice, simple, and elegant tool that you can make incredibly complicated procedures with, and you can really make quite sophisticated as far as how you market it. One of the other things that each of these tools will have is the ability for you to create email templates. Now, personally, I don't use any of the templates. I like a very clean email format, and when I send my emails, I don't like a lot of fanciness, but you can create really fancy looking newsletters with each of them, and they enable that, and they enable the creation of that, and they actually just give you ideas about what you should be putting into your newsletter. And if you're, say, a realtor, it's tremendous for you to be able to see the templates that they have that are designed for promoting real estate. And they even show you where the pictures go and how big the picture should be and what sort of pictures you should have and where the description goes, and allows you to kind of work within their format to make your content look that much more professional. But Pedro, the bottom line is, if you're thinking about getting into the world of email marketing or sending out newsletters, one of these tools is the place that you want to start. I recommend probably starting with MailChimp. Sign up for the free account, take their training and their tutorials, and go slowly through the process of learning and understanding what an email autoresponder or email marketing tool will do for you. As an online marketer, somebody who makes their living from the internet, this is the most important tool that I use on a daily basis, because this is the one that puts me in contact with my community directly and allows me to talk to them and ultimately to ask them if they want to purchase something downstream. And that's really where business happens. I hope you found today's video to be useful. Now, there's three ways for you to stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. The first is, please subscribe to this newsletter, as we were talking about. Subscribe to our newsletter. You can also subscribe to our YouTube channel, which I would appreciate greatly as well. Dotto Tech is also a community-funded channel. We're supported through the generosity of our viewers at the crowdfunding site Patreon. I encourage you to drop by our Patreon page and take a look at the perks that are included with being a supporter of Dotto Tech. We appreciate you having a look. That's it for today. Till next time, I am Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.